Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech. And yesterday, Apple announced watchOS 8. watchOS 8 Beta 1 is now available to developers, and the public beta will probably be out in July, as that's when they said iOS 15 would be available to public beta testers as well. So along with this, Apple also announced iOS 15, iPadOS 15 Beta 1, as well as tvOS 15 Beta 1, and macOS 12 Monterey. So all of those are in beta 1, and if you're a developer, you can download and try them out now. Now, the good thing is the supported devices with watchOS 8 are the same as watchOS 7. So if you have a Series 3 or newer up to a Series 6 Apple Watch like this one, you'll have support for your device. You may not have all of the features, but you'll at least be able to install watchOS 8 on your device. Now, this came in at a pretty large 1.2 gigabytes to install on the Series 6 Apple Watch. It can vary depending on which version you're coming from, but the overall install did take a little while, and now it's working fine. And let's talk about the features. And the first thing is the always-on display. If you have a Series 5 or Series 6 Apple Watch, you'll have an always-on display, and it will now allow for more apps to work with it, such as alarms, maps, and stopwatch. Or if you have a third-party app, they can opt to make it work as well. Now, I don't believe the feature is working just yet, so if I reset this and hit start, it doesn't seem to be working with stopwatch, for example. It just goes to a black display, but it should work by the time it's released. Apple sometimes doesn't finish all of the features. And with this, they did update one of the watch faces. However, that's not available yet either. So if we slide over, you'll see I have a Photos watch face. They did update a Photos with portrait mode watch face, but it's not available yet. So if you go and add new, you'll see that there's a new watch face selector here. So it gives a little more detail. And so there's a new watch face selector, and you can go through all of the different ones. But with Photos, there will be a portrait photo mode with a multi-layer photo with depth. So that's not available yet, but it will be available in the future. So they did show it off. It looks like this, and it was shown at WWDC, but it's not available just yet. So they've changed the way the watch face picker looks, as well as added that watch face. Now, along with that, they've redesigned an app. So we'll go back here. And if we scroll up to music, music gets a redesign. Now, they've changed it slightly. It doesn't look terribly different, but you've got your different albums here you can scroll through. And then, of course, your library and other things. So they did give it a small redesign. It's a little bit updated just to be more consistent with what we have across iOS, for example. So not a huge change, but it is updated a little bit with recently added. You'll see it's a little bit choppy there when I'm scrolling, but recently added and more. So that has been updated. They also updated the watch with a new section called Mindfulness. So Mindfulness is more of a category. And if we go into Mindfulness, we'll hit done here. You'll see that there's two different things. We have Reflect and Breathe. Breathe was there before under its own app, but now it's been moved under Mindfulness. So if we go into Breathe, they've changed the animation a little bit. So we'll wait for it here, and I'll show you that. So it will take just a moment, and you can see the animation has changed a little bit. So they've changed the animation slightly. And then, like I said, they've added a new feature called Mindfulness called Reflect. So it says, take a moment to reflect. It says, remind yourself of a recent challenge you've overcome. Think about the traits you have that helped. So this changes every time, and it sort of gives you something to think about to get your mind off what maybe you're working on. And you'll see there's a nice animation, and this changes as well. So it just gives you a minute to reflect on something, to try and get your mind off of whatever you're doing to relax a little bit. So it goes along with Breathe under Mindfulness. Now, they've updated the Sleep app as well. Sleep can now track your respiratory rate. So if you're using the Sleep app and you want it to regularly track your respiratory rate, you can do that. So if we go to the Health app on the iPhone under Health, you'll see that we have all of our normal summary here. However, if we go to Browse and then we go down to Respiratory, scroll down, you have respiratory rate. Now, if you're using it for sleep, it can track this and keep track of it and sort of notice trends based off your respiratory rate when you're sleeping and moving and how you're breathing. So that's something they've added with this as well. They've also added walking steadiness, and this is something they talked about with iOS 15, for example. So they've added that, and it goes along with mobility. And under mobility, you can set up walking steadiness. So maybe you have someone that maybe has a little bit trouble walking, you can actually set this up to help them realize maybe when they need to sit down, for example, because they're becoming very unsteady. And you'll see here, it says your iPhone can measure your walking steadiness and send a notification if you're at an elevated risk of falling in the next year. So it will let you know, hopefully it notifies you right away, but it gives you an understanding of what it is and you can see more about it. So that's something that's a little bit different. Now, along with iOS 15, you have new focus mode. So if you scroll down here, you'll see there's do not disturb like we have before. And we have different modes such as work. I have a focus mode I set up on my iPhone called work, and we can turn it on until I leave based on where I'm at. So you'll see here that if we go back, it says work and it has a new little icon here. So it's a focus mode that you can set up to help you focus on what matters most. So it will stop notifications from things you don't care about, and you can set it up and customize it. Now in the future, it can actually notify someone that you're working and you can get back to them later. So you have that in this update. Now they've also updated the home app. And in the home app, we'll go into office, for example, they've updated it to give you the status of your different things at the top, along with intercom. So if you have a HomePod mini or a HomePod, you can use it as an intercom. It's giving you the status of different devices, so it can't find one of them. If we go into this one, you can see there's different outlets here on that outlet. And if we go back, you'll see we even can go down and go to cameras now. So if we go into cameras, this is the room I'm actually in. You can see that camera and you can set different defaults and things like that. So they've updated the home app to be more useful and give you more information right up front. Now it also will notify you if maybe you have a HomeKit enabled doorbell and door lock. If someone rings the doorbell, for example, it can pop up on your screen and give you a suggestion of maybe unlocking that lock. So it will use that as intelligence and sort of give you the idea that maybe you want to do this. So that's something a little bit new. Now, the next thing is a new app called Find Items. Now, this goes along with AirTags. So we have Find Devices, just like we did before, Find Items, and Find People. It's basically the Find My app with the sections at the bottom on iPhone split up into different apps on watchOS. So if we go into Find Items, you can see there's my backpack. Tap on this. It actually locates it on the map, says where I am, and it's with me. And if I scroll down, I can play a sound, get directions, notify when found, notify when left behind. And it says lost mode enabled on 4:30. So I was trying that out when I first got them. So that's a new app that's included with watchOS 8. Now they've also included some new workouts. So if we go down to workouts here, go all the way down, workout, there should be a couple new workouts that they've included with watchOS 8. So we'll scroll down and we should have two new ones. And you'll see one of the new ones is Pilates. So they've added that as far as a workout goes, and then Tai Chi. So those are two new workouts that they've added. Also, if you use Apple Fitness Plus, they've added seven new workouts to Fitness Plus with Jeanette Jenkins. And there's going to be an artist spotlight series with music artists such as Lady Gaga and more later this month. So if you're using the fitness app, you'll see those there. So we'll go to fitness and Fitness Plus. You'll have new updates to this later this month with different things for maybe featured artists. And that's not here yet, but it will be added a little bit later. Now they've also updated the Photos app. And in the Photos app, you have memories, and then you have featured photos and favorites. So far, featured is not working for me. If we go into memories, we now have a new photo mosaic. So you can see it looks a little bit different here. We can tap on those and look at them if we want. And of course, share this. And so photos has been updated a little bit. And then if we share it, we can share with regular friends or family. And if we scroll down, we now have the option to share with messages or mail. So we can share that photo to either one of those. And within messages and mail, there's some updates as far as sending messages also. So maybe I'll go into messages and maybe add a message. And under add a message, we now have the option to dictate here. We can scribble or even type or add emoji here, all built into the same interface. So we'll just do a quick message. Hi, how are you today? We'll hit done. We'll go back into that message. And if I tap on this, we can delete part of that here, or we can scroll through to find what we want it to say, Or if we tap again, we can use the digital crown to more finely tune where we actually want to go in and type. So that has been updated in messages. So we can go back and forth. We can also add an emoji here. So you can add your latest emoji. You can add multiple emoji. Even though this doesn't make any sense, you can add multiple emoji, add a GIF or GIF if you want to. So we can go cancel this and we'll just go back here to messages. And under messages, we have this little app icon or app shelf. Tap on this, we can add a GIF or GIF. So we'll tap on this here. And now we can select from whichever one we want and we can search as well. So we have all of those built into messages, basically the same thing we have with iPhone. So we have those options now. Now on iOS 15, Apple updated the weather app. And in weather, they've updated it with some new animations and more, but they've added some new notifications on your watch for that, such as next hour precipitation, and it supports severe storm notifications. So it will notify you on your watch. Maybe you're away from your phone. It will let you know there. So that's something that's updated. They've also added support for ultra wideband car keys, for example, and then also live headphone audio exposure. So maybe you're using headphones and you want to see what's actually going on with noise. So if I play some music here and I put an AirPod in and I'm playing a song in my AirPod Pro, and if I go back to the main screen, swipe up, go down to the audio notifications, you'll see it's showing me the actual noise level in real time. So it's keeping track of that and letting me know what it is. I can turn it up and down, of course, and you'll see the decibels change. So that's something that's new in this update. Now with watchOS 8 and iOS 15, they've added the ability to use hand gestures to control your Apple Watch for those that may not be able to touch it with another hand, for example. So there's a new accessibility feature. So first, if we go into our iPhone and then we go to the Watch app, go to accessibility, and under accessibility, we have assistive touch. So we can turn on assistive touch, and it says turn on assistive touch. It allows you to navigate Apple Watch using one hand gestures. So we'll try it out. And you can pinch, tap the pointer finger to pinch, double pinch, tap pointer finger to thumb twice quickly, clench, close your hand into a fist, or double clench, close your hand into a fist twice quickly. So we'll try it out on Apple Watch. So I'll put the Apple Watch on my wrist. And you'll see here, let's see if it works. And it says by tapping your pointer finger and thumb, it says pinch recognized. We'll hit done, double pinch. So I'll pinch twice. It recognized that, double pinch recognized. It says clench. So we'll clench our fist. We'll try a whole hand there. It says, let's give it another go. Clench recognized. And then there will be a double clench. So we can do that. We'll try it again. And it recognized that. So it actually works there. So try it out on Apple Watch. We'll go back and we'll turn it on. Now on the home screen, you can use this as well. So if I pinch, it selects. If I double pinch, it goes up. Double pinch again, it goes to the next complication. So you can do that. And then you can double clench and it goes to different options. So press crown, dismiss. You'll see there's different options here. So it's a little bit tricky to get used to, but it's very helpful if you needed this option to go through different things. So eventually you'll be able to do more control. Right now it looks like you can just go through things and we'll double clench, select that, and we're back home. And again, we're back. So that gives you an idea. It recognizes those gestures. Now there's two other small changes. One is an enhanced family setup feature. And then also there's a new school mode animation. So if we go into school mode, it looks like it's a little bit different. So it's a school mode. You don't have access to everything. And if I want to go home, you have to turn the digital crown to exit. So it looks a little bit different. Tap on exit and we're out. So those are all of the major changes in watchOS 8. It's possible there's other small changes as well throughout, but so far that's what I've discovered and the Apple's talked about. And as you can see here under about, we're on version 8. So those of you that were wondering the build number, it's 19R5266Q. So it's a version that needs quite a few updates until it's out. And talking about when it will be out, well, this should be out in September, usually along the lines of iPhone 13's release, along with iOS 15, for example. And that leads me to, should you install watchOS 8? Well, I would say not unless you have an extra one or you're willing to send it into Apple if you have a problem. There is no way to go back connecting this to a computer, for example. So it's not easy to go back to a previous version if you're having problems with it. You generally have to send it to Apple. They can wipe it and then refresh it for you. And it can take a few days. So I don't normally recommend watchOS betas to anyone unless maybe the public beta is out where it's a little bit more stable. So I might want to wait until then. As far as battery life, well, I took this off the charger this morning. It seems to be okay. It's at 82%. It's been off the charger for 3 or 4 hours at this point, and it seems to be okay. It's been on quite a bit for this video, so that will bring the battery down a bit. But in general, it seems to be pretty fast. You've seen how it responds here. It's missing a couple features, but hopefully we'll have those in the next beta. But so far, it's doing well. If there's anything else you found, let me know in the comments below. And of course, I'll link a wallpaper for you in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.